Welcome to my second students. Now we are going to discuss about electrostatic charges and fields from the second year physics. The weight of the unit 2 plus 4 to the 6 months. Okay. Now, what is the electricity? What is the electricity? Electricity is means charges. Bunch of signs. This is study of electric charge. This is study of electrical charges. But which are move or impressed. Now, types of electricity is two types. One is electrostatics. Electrostatics. Another is current electricity. Current electricity. Okay. What is electrostatics? Electrostatics is this is study to only rest charges. Study of rest charges. Study of rest charges. And current electricity means it is study of only moving charges. Moving charges. Okay. Now electricity has two types. One is electrostatics. It is study to only rest charges. Current electricity only more charges. Okay. But whatever the charge, what is charge? Charge means it is a fundamental property of matter and it is formed into one body to another body. That is known as charge. Charge is denoted by Q. The units of the charge is coulombs. Next, types of charges. According to electrification, the charges are two types. One is positive charge. One is positive, which is the plus Q. Another is the negative charge, which is the negative minus Q. But what is the electrification? What is the electrification? Electrification means when the two bodies are rubbing to each other, after that the bodies are attracted to another body, the process is called electrification. Once again, what is the electrification? When the two bodies are rubbing to each other, after that the bodies are attracted by another body, the process is called electrification. But due to electron, then according to electrification, the charges are two types. One is the positive and one is the negative. What is the positive charge? Positive charge means it is losses of electron of a body or deficiency of electron of a body is called positive charge. What is the negative charge? It is excess of electron or gain of electron of a body is called negative charge. So again, what is the positive charge? What is it? Losses of electron or deficiency of electron of a body is called positive. But negative means it is the excess of electron or gain electron of a body is known as negative charge. Now, for example, you know the sodium chloride spring is the NaCl. NaCl is sodium chloride. Now, here, two atoms. For example, sodium. The sodium atom is one electron mass, it gained positive ion as one electron. The atomic number of sodium is 11, it is the one electron is the more, it is the 10 plus 1. Then the sodium is gained positive charge. Now, so what is the positive charge? Loss of electron or deficiency of electron is known as the positive charge. Again, chlorine, the chlorine atomic number is so much, 17. Now, the chlorine plus one electron added to the chlorine, then it will use chlorine ion is the minus. Then 7 plus 1 is another, is the 18. Now, excess of electron, the negative charge. Loss of electron is the positive charge. Okay, so is the positive and negative. Now, next we will discuss about properties of charges. Properties of charge. Now the first property of the charge is the additive nature. attitude, nature, or
attitude, nature, property.
What is the meaning of the attitude, nature? Now we consider an isolated system. It is the isolated system. It has many more particles. The particle have some charge. The particles is the Q1, is the minus Q2, and Q3, and Q4, minus Q4. It's how many particles on Q1. For now, the algebraic, that means plus or minus, the algebraic sum of total charges of the an isolated system is equal to the net charge of the system. Now we came back. The Q net is equal to Q1 minus Q2 plus Q3 minus Q4, so on Qn. This one is additive nature of the charge. Once again, what is the statement of particle nature? Once again, now the total algebraic sum of total charge of an isolated system is equal to net charge of this system, that is known as energy nature of the charge. It is the first. Now the second one, which is the most important property of the charge. Charge is quantized. What is the meaning of the charge? The most important. The total body of the charge, it is Q, is equal to integral multiple of electron charge. So we can write M E plus or minus. Now from this equation, Q means charge, the total body of the charge. N is integral multiple of the N equal to 1, 2, 3, so on. Electron, E means electron charge, then E is equal to 1.602 to 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. What is the meaning of charge is quantized. The total charge of the body is equal to integral multiple of electron charge. That is why charge is quantized. Here, U means charge, N means integral multiple, that is equal to 1, 2, 3, so on. E means electron charge, the value of the electron charge is equal to 1.602 to 10 to the power of minus 10 coulombs. Now the third property, charge is conserved. What is the meaning of the charge is conserved? It is simple. The total charge of an isolated system is remains constant. The total charge of an isolated system is remains constant. Or charge is neither recreated nor destroyed, but is transformed to one body to another body. So this is known as charge is quantized. These are properties of the charges. Second, additive nature. What is the additive nature? The algebraic sum of total charges of an isolated system that is equal to the net charge of the system, that is known as additive nature. The second one, charge is quantized. The total charge of any body is equal to integral multiple of electron charge. Is the charge is quantized. Now this equation Q means charge, N means number of electrons are integral multiple of number N equal 1, 2, 3, so on. E means electron charge, the value of electron charge 1 minus 6 and 2 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. So finally, charge is answer. What is the charge is answer? The total charge of an isolated system is remains constant. All charges neither be created nor destroyed, but is transformed from one body to another body. These are properties of the charges. Now, next, notice let's say the small problem from this formula charge is quantized. What is the problem? The small simple problem is the most important problem. How many electrons constitute in one coulomb charge? Okay, let's once again with the question. How many electrons so all constitute in one coulomb charge? From this statement, now we find the how many electrons. But which given the problem? It is the charge given. The charge Q is equal to how much? One. Okay. From which part of electron? The electron charge. Electron charge is electron charge, then E is equal to 1.602 into the power minus 10 coulombs. Okay, which part now from this equation? How many electrons from this equation to this point? What is the formula? Q is equal to N E. Q is equal to N E. Now the from this equation, which part? N equal to Q bar E. N equal to Q. Now already given Q is equal to how much? 1 coulomb. But E means electron charge 1.602 into the power of minus 19. Now substitute this equation and find it out for the electrons. Then N equal to Q means 1 bar. Electron charge how much? 1.602 into the power of minus 19. Now we do simplify this our problem. Then N equal to how much? 6.25 into 10 to the power of the 18 electrons or day in 1 coulomb charge. This is the important problem from this, which is not charges on ice.